Welkom to Revelation 17. It is different. We start with an introduction because there are many opinions and explanations about who are the 10 kings, the 7 heads, and the woman. It is very dangerous if you believe in them. So let's take a look at a few who is on the internet and on commentaries. I found one on BibleProphecyRevealed.com, which is telling the 10 nations of the beast spoken in Revelation 17 and Ezekiel 38 will unite, having the same kind of belief, the Islam belief. The 10 nations, according to them, are Gog, Magog, Hos, Meshech, Tubal, Persia, Ethiopia, Libya, Comar, Tarshish. And they say these 10 nations were once located in the territories of the following Islamitic nations: Turkey, Syria, Jordan, Iran, Irak, Sudan, Egypt, Libya, Afghanistan, Uzbekistan, Turkmenistan, Tajikistan, Kyrgyzstan en Kazachstan. Well, to me, what they are saying, this is the next world order and an Islamic union that will bring great persecution against Christians and Jews. This event is known in the Bible as the Battle of Gog and Magog or Armageddon. Well, I'm very sorry, but I disagree heavily about this countries they mention, they have two Islamitic faith and they are fighting one another. Also Jordan, Egypt, they already make peace with Israel. Now we have the Arabic Emirates, which is making peace with Israel. Soon will follow more, also Lebanon, and the great danger is Iraq and Turkey, which share the same Islamic faith, and they want to re-establish the Islamic state. So these countries are out of the pictures. The Battle of Gog and Magog, yes, that is a battle, and I will come back to that later, but certainly it is another battle than the one of Armageddon. Gog and Magog will occur first, and how soon I don't know, but with all the peace treaties going on, we can expect very soon that battle. Why can we expect that battle? Because, I come back to that later on, they are wishes to have the gas and oil fields which Israel encountered, as well as Greece, and they wish to establish the Islamic state, but primarily the richness of Israel. Turkey and Iraq will attack Israel, but God will interfere, as is written in Ezekiel 38 and 39, and God will interfere and destroy these armies of Turkey and Iraq due to a nature intervention. Earthquakes, hailstones, thunders, and Israel does not need to defend himself. Later on I shall already explain why the United States will not help Israel, because the United States is already out of the picture. So this one we can omit. Then we have the explanation, the eight kings of Revelation, the next and last pope. They say that five popes are fallen, Revelation 17 verse 10, and they are referring, why I don't know, to Pius 11, Pius 12, John 24, Paul 6, John Paul 1, they are referring, they were in the power between 1922 until 1978. So then we come to the one is in Revelation. They say that is John Paul II, who reigned from 1978 until 2005. He was seriously wounded in 1981. They say he is the sixth king, but the popes are not kings. But here they state he is the sixth king, the one is. Then came in the year 2005 Benedict 16, and he ruled only for a very short time. And then came the eighth king, who was, and they say that the devil from the bottomless pit, that is again John Paul II, the eighth king, the beast that was and is not even, he is the eighth and of the seven and cove. No prediction. Revelation 17:11. Well, the Pope is not a king. This is a, I think, a silly interpretation of Revelation. He is not the eighth king. The Pope never was a king. He was a Pope. So that is not true. Then they say that the United Nations, that is the beast spoken in Revelation 17, and the United Nations is heavily supported by the United States, the Red Dragon, but the United Nations is very weak, has no power at all. Although it is seated in New York and a lot of money comes from the United States. So that's also not the Ten Nations and the Red Dragon. I found another interesting explanation. Revelation 17, the verses 10 to 11, King James Version. And there are seven kings, five are fallen, and one is, and the other is not yet come, and when he come, he must continue a short space, and the beast that was and is not, even he is the eighth and is of the seven and goes into perdition. I really found this very interesting. They are referring to the presidents of the United States. Have a look at this picture with the images. They were all with a degree of the Freemasons, and they are stating that the first king is James Carter Jr. The second king is Ronald Reagan. The third king, George Bush. The fourth king, William Jefferson Clinton. And the fifth king, George Bush. These five kings who failed, they failed to protect Israel. They were against Israel and become to the sixth king. This is Barack Obama. He was replaced by the seventh king. This is Donald Trump. And I really find this very interesting. They say that he will continue, so he will be elected again in November 2020, and he will reign until the rapture of the church. And thereafter, the eighth king, who disappeared, he will appear again, and that is Barack Obama. He will return, he will ascend. So what is interesting is that nowadays the Democrats are doing everything to gain the power. Donald Trump is a restrainer. He defends the Constitution. Many in the Senate, they are in favor of the Constitution, the laws of God, of Moses, the Congress. They are all in favor. Well, the Democrats will get rid of the complete Constitution. They are in favor of abortus, euthanasia, and George Bush is in favor, and the present Republicans, they are in favor of protection of life. So if this is true, then Donald Trump remains in power until the rapture of the church, and when the Christians, all those Republicans in the Congress House, in the Senate, when they are taken up into heaven, then the restrainer has gone and the Democrats has free power. The United States will fall to a chaos and Israel is without any protection of the United States. So that's this is not what I'm thinking, which is the explanation of the eighth king. Also, we read earlier in Revelation that the United States, North and South America will be destroyed. One third of the earth will be destroyed. We already read. So the United States is out of the picture. That's it. That is the short introduction, and I will continue with Revelation 17. Revelation 17. So, with this introduction, the Antichrist has to be a Jew. Yes, the Antichrist needs to be a Jew because the Jewish people will never allow a heathen, a Gentile, into the new rebuilt temple. No heathen, no Gentile will be allowed to enter the temple in Jerusalem. So all will take place in Europe. The judgment upon the great harlot. In the Old Testament, the metaphor of adultery was frequently used of Israel as God's faithless wife. Israel, the Jews, the faithless wife of God, turning to other gods, idols, and as well as commercial gain. We can think as Babylon as a symbol of human civilization with all its lust for richness, wealth, luxury, and against of God and order. The reaction of God, including the abortus, euthanasia, offering of babies and children to Satan, Baal, the great harlot who is seated upon many waters. This cannot be the city of Rome, nor the Vatican City, because the river Tiber flows through the city of Rome. So when we need to think about the great harlot who is seated upon many waters, then we need to think about a city like Amsterdam, with is built upon pillars with a lot of canals, or we can think about Berlin, which is built on a swamp. Only the people in the Great Tribulations will know which will be the city Babylon. The old Babylon, before Christ, the old Babylon of King Nebuchadnezzar, he seduced the old world with his fornication. The Antichrist will seduce the complete world in everything against God, seduce all people on earth and force to worship the beast and to accept the mark. Only those who are very strong, they will not worship and refuse the mark of the beast. John is carried into a wilderness, and the Greek word means here an uncultivated region with a few people. And John saw a woman sitting on a scarlet beast, scarlet indicating the intimate relation with his master Satan. So this wilderness indicates an occult place and the inner relationship of the woman with Satan. Well, on many waters we can say the open relationship with the many nations on earth. Full of blasphemous names is a reference to the self deification of the Antichrist and his demand for the worship of his followers, that he will be worshipped as a god. The woman was arrayed in purple and scarlet, full of gold, precious stones, silver, full of luxury. The woman is showing her luxury, her wealth, her power, her greatness. Purple and scarlet were in the old days very costly and was only affordable by kings and very, very rich people. And this desire for this wealth, richness, luxury, that entices men away from God. Verse 5, her name of mystery. The mystery that in her title is included her object. The abominations and impurities of her fornication to lead people away from God and to towards the Antichrist to be worshipped as a god. It shows her drunkenness through the blood. She drank the blood of the saints who she murdered. Verse 6, John marveled greatly. A better translation is, John was greatly amazed. And the angel asked him, why are you amazed? And the angel tells him that he will explain the mystery of the woman and the beast, indicating the unity between the woman and the beast. So close was the interrelationship between the two. It is one mystery, the woman and the beast. The civilization will support the beast and the woman. And the beast passes through three stages. It was, that is, it had an existence in the past. The old Roman Imperium was seized in 476. It is not. There is a time that it doesn't exist. And it is coming up again in the 1900s, in the 20th century, the European Union, if you may say so. There is a time that it doesn't exist, the Imperial, Roman Imperial. It is to ascend from the bottomless pit and go to perdition. It will have a future. It will manifest itself again. We are seeing now again the European Union, but still it isn't. It is, it will ascend from the bottomless pit. After the rapture of the church, the Roman Empire will ascend from the bottomless pit. The bottomless pit, this is Apsis. 10 kings will rise, European Union, and the Antichrist will appear. The Apsis is not hell, not inferno. Why I'm saying that is that, let's go to Matthew 8, verses 28 to 34. Jesus allows the evil spirits to enter in the swine, and they fall in the sea, they fall in the abyss, and they ask not to be tormented before their time. Not before their time, meaning the eternal punishment in the lake of fire. So the evil spirits are now kept in Apsis, and then they will be released after the rapture of the church. And if I follow the converted Jew Amir, you can assist his videos on YouTube, Behold Israel. He says that Turkey and Iraq, they will attack Israel because they risk the richness, all the gas and all. We have the war of Ezekiel, Ezekiel 38 and 39. They will, perhaps including Russia, they will go to attack Israel, but they will be destroyed by God, by earthquake, hailstones, thunder, lightnings. It is God himself who will protect Israel, and if it is correct, then starts the peace, the start of the great tribulation, the peace of the beast for 3.5 years. The temple will be rebuilt, the Islamists will be wiped out, and they will rebuild very quickly the temple, and after 3.5 years, the Antichrist will sit and take his seat in the temple. The Jews will flee away to the wilderness, to the desert, and 3.5 years of persecution will be there, and people on the whole world will be forced to accept the mark 666 and to worship Satan, the beast, the false prophet. So that's what might occur. We don't know. We don't know at this moment who are the 10-7 kings with the heads. People, the restrainer, first need to be removed. The true believers, the true Christians, the followers, and the guidance of the Holy Spirit, they first need to be removed from earth, and the people who stay behind on earth, they will know who is the Antichrist and the 10 kings. So don't let yourself be misled. It is God who is in control. So after, at the end of the Great Tribulation, and let's jump in verse 13, we jump to the end of the Great Tribulation, to the War of Megiddo, Revelation 16, verse 6, and the second return of Jesus on the Mount Zion, Zechariah 14. And all the Jews and Israelites will see him. Who will see him? All the Jews will see him who they have pierced. Zechariah 12, verse 10. They will see who they have pierced, that is Jesus Christ. And all Israel will be saved. Psalm 130, verse 4, and Romans 11, verse 26. All Israel will see Jesus Christ, who they have pierced, and all Israel will be saved. So, the Christians, the church, is not the replacement of Israel, of the Jews. The complete earth in worship of the beast, people, multitudes, nations, and tongues will raise and fight against the lamp, and the lamp will conquer them. For it is God who have given them over them to their lust, to their desire for witnesses, to desire to do their own will, to the egoism, and they are one mind with the beast, and the lamb will conquer them. And we end with verse 18. This might be a symbolic interpretation of the woman. She is the great city which has dominion over the kings of the earth. The woman will be conquered by Jesus Christ, the Lamb. That's it. We do not have an answer yet. Who are the kings? Who is the Antichrist? 2020. Yes, I think the Antichrist is already alive, but we don't know who. Don't be mistaken. The name of the Antichrist will be revealed after the rapture of the church, not before. the true Christians who live under the control of the Holy Spirit, we are called to proclaim the gospel, and we will not know the name of the Antichrist. That will be revealed at the beginning of the Great Tribulation. So be awakened, don't be misled by all kinds of people who tell that the Christians are the replacement of the Jews. The state Israel is given by God in 1948. It is God who is bringing back the Jews to Israel. It is God who protect Israel. It is God who is making that the Arabic countries is making peace with Israel. That's all according to the will of God. So don't be misled by false prophets, because that are false prophets. Stay to the Bible, study the Bible, study the Bible in its context, and believe and follow Jesus as your Savior and Lord, and live under the control of the Holy Spirit. Glorify, respect the laws of God, all Christian values, Ten Commandments, respect life, living according to the will of God. And don't be misled by false interpretations of the Bible. Thank you, Lord, that you have given your word, that you have revealed the future, that there are many on internet, on YouTube, who are proclaiming the truth. Please protect us against all the false prophets who give an incorrect interpretation of the Bible. Open our eyes, help me to understand your word, and help me to live according to your honor and glory, so that I will be taken at the rapture of the church. Amen.